Before starting my geometric accent wall, I had to remove the applied molding that was framing this chalkboard. Chalkboard paint tends to go on very thick, so I used my Festool sander to smooth out the rough edges and the overall texture. This left me with a good starting point for my new accent wall. Once I was happy with how smooth the wall was, I primed over the chalkboard paint using Stix primer, which I got at my local Benjamin Mora store. This is one of my favorite primers since it does exactly what its name says it does. It sticks to everything. So I knew it would adhere well to the chalkboard paint and provide me with a great base for my next colors. After the primer was dry, I skim coated around the edges of the chalkboard with finishing mud. I left this to dry overnight, and in the morning I was able to sand it nice and smooth and then prime it one more time before starting to tape. This is the design that will be featured on the wall. All of these colors are by BEHR and they are listed below. I started my first block of color by measuring 20 inches off of the right wall. The measurements weren't 100% accurate, since walls are usually never really that straight, so I set up my laser level, which gave me a perfectly straight line to base my tape off of. I used delicate frog tape for this entire process. This tape is great and it worked so well for me on this wall. It is delicate enough to be used on fresh paint and it leaves nice, crisp lines, which is really important doing this geometric wall. It does recommend that you wait 24 hours before applying this tape to fresh paint. However, I completed this entire wall in one day with no problems. Some of the paint had only dried for about an hour before I applied the tape. The first color I used is called Everblooming. Remember that all of the color information is listed in the description below. I used a 2-inch brush, which is just my personal preference, and then a 6-inch whiz roller, which worked really well on these shapes just because of the size of them. As soon as I finished rolling, I was able to peel off the frog tape, and I was left with a nice, crisp line. With the easy part done, it was time to start on the triangles. I measured 26 inches across the top of the wall from my painted line. And then I took the same measurement off the ceiling downwards. This leaves me with a perfect triangle ready for tape. While I was waiting for the paint to dry before taping over it, I started taping out my next section. This was another 36 inches past my last measurements, both across the top and down. Once I finished taping off my third section, the first color that I painted was dry enough to tape over. I was careful when taping not to push down the entire width of the tape, while still making sure that the paintable edge had a nice tight seal. The second color I used is called Silver Bullet, and this is used in two places on this wall. These whiz rollers really do come in handy when you're doing tight spaces like this. It lets you get right in the corners without having to brush out too far. Once again, I peeled the frog tape off only a minute or two after finishing rolling. While waiting for my first silver bullet triangle to dry, I taped out the second triangle in the same color. I measured 23.5 inches down off of the ceiling and 54 inches from the left wall along the top of the baseboard. As I got into the flow of the process, each shape got faster as I got more comfortable with the measurements and the taping. Also keep in mind that I did 2 to 3 coats of each color before removing the tape and moving on to the next section. With adequate time to dry, I taped over the top right silver bullet triangle and started on color number 3. This color is called Island Hopping. It is hard to see in the video, I know, but it is a light pink, quite a few shades lighter than the first color that I did there on the right-hand side. As I peel the tape off here, you can really start to see the definition between the colors and the shapes. It's really now all starting to come together. To start the next section, I measured 31.5 inches off of the intersection between Everblooming and Island Hopping. I then used the laser level to help tape off the straight edge. This next color is called Rio Sky. Cut the edge of the knife and it hurts just a little. Yeah, I think I got more and more excited with each section and each piece of tape that I pulled off. It's starting to look good! Since I painted the rest of this room, I was able to work on other things while I was waiting for paint to dry. So no, I didn't literally sit and watch paint dry. So now on to section number 5. Actually, color number 5. Which is our final color. But no, not the final section. The final section is actually one of the existing colors. Stay tuned, you will find out very soon. This final triangle required no measurements as it filled in the negative space between Rio Sky, the blue, and Everblooming, the darker pink, and came to a point in the bottom left corner. The final color is called Lunchbox. Don't forget that all of these colors are listed in the description below, so go check them out. This yellow really adds some contrast and that wow factor. I mean, come on, how can you not be excited about it now? So this is it, the final section. And to be honest, I was nervous about this section, and you'll see why. I couldn't wrap my head around how it would work, taking it from drawing to the wall, but I trusted my measurements and it all worked out. Using the laser level, I measured 6 inches off of the last triangle, Rio Sky. That's the blue one. I then used 2-inch frog tape, which is the thickest frog tape that you can get, to tape off stripes. I taped a total of 4 stripes with 6 inches in between. Because I painted the wall white underneath, that's what color the stripes will be. I painted the entire section over the striped tape using Island Hopping. As I pulled off the final pieces of tape, I was so happy to see that it worked out exactly as I wanted to. The stripes are perfect and they tie the whole space together. Doing this geometric accent wall was so much fun, and it's just the perfect addition to this kid's craft room. Thank you so much for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please don't forget to like and subscribe to support Tridium Paint. Thanks guys, see you soon.